The Office of the Auditor General was asked in September 2021 to conduct a forensic audit into the expenditure of the COVID-19 funds as part of the resolutions made by Parliament after an initial probe into the expenditure of COVID-19 funds. Today, the Auditor General, John Mwanga, delivered the report. Mwanga made the revelation in his forensic investigation report into the COVID-19 funds released to ministries, departments and agencies between 2019 to 2021 that he presented before Parliament, where he queried the number of mice procured that wasn't concurrent with the initial details in the procurement.
We wonder how you budget for purchase of 8 mice at an exorbitant fee, and you end up buying only 4 mice at 48 million shillings. I've not known the exchange rate of a dollar to double. It has been stable. At most, a dollar has gone is 3.8. So I do not see how the price of a mouse, which was quoted by the very people who are buying these mice, has now made them buy only 4 at a price of 48 million
each at 12 million.
Sincerely, I've not seen an abuse that is bigger than this.
Let's get serious. You can't buy a rat at 48 million or at 40 million plus. Stealing needs wisdom. Which kind of rat is that one? So certain programs like this, sometimes it will be real, and because of the negativity and all the corruption that is always witnessed during such epidemics, it makes people suspicious. Now, next time, like now we have Ebola, you see people are still suspicious. They think people want to eat money. It is because of history.
The report also revealed that the lab and Mulhouse under Makerere University and PCR and antibody diagnostic kits projects, which had a total approval proposal budget of 2.92 billion shillings to manufacture COVID-19 vaccines, received a total of 3.83 billion shillings with sufficient justification, which had resulted into a total overpayment of 904 million shillings. Details from the audit report indicated that the Ministry of Science and Technology received funds for COVID in 2 batches, with the first of 5.3 billion shillings paid in 2019 to 2020 and 31 billion shillings in 2020 and 2021. The forensic audit also faulted the Minister of Science and Technology for spending 5.25 billion shillings and 15.88 billion shillings for the procurement of research equipment from suppliers who hadn't been qualified, urging that the purchase didn't cater for a research in market price as stipulated in the procurement regulations.
To accountability, there is no donor who will give money to you when you are not you don't want to be accountable, or when they know you will steal it. So as we move on, we'll have more of those cases whereby development partners don't want to deal directly with government. They want to give money to NGOs to account for their money, because it's taxpayers' money in their country.
Upon receiving the report, the Speaker has ordered the Auditor General, John Mwanga, to conduct a value-for-money audit into the money government has injected into both Atiak Sugar Factory and Roko Construction Company. The directive comes at a time reports emerged that government recently gifted Atiak Sugar Factory 127 billion shillings.
Because if we're in partnership, we need to know how much has been done, how much money of ours is there, what are we benefiting. A case in point now is Bujagali. There are a lot of problems in Bujagali. And if a report is coming to the floor, you'll be surprised how much money we have injected in Bujagali and how much the other ones have injected. Actually, we're expecting them to pay us back our money. There's a big problem there. Then the recoverable costs in the oil sector arising from the production sharing agreements.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.